My firstborn is 3.5 years old. Mm-hmm. Sort of. Okay, she's turning 4 in April. Mm-hmm. And then my second born came 1.5 years later, mm-hmm. after the second born. So she's 2.5. Mm-hmm. And then now this one, by the time she's born, there will be a 2.5 year gap between the second born and now the third born. So okay. there's a first born, 1.5 years, second born, 2.5 years, then third born. The second pregnancy was a bit tiring for me. Okay. And I had a big fight to stop Mercy mm-hmm. from breastfeeding. But even the neighbors can give their story. She used to cry the whole night. And then she was one of those kids who never liked their food, mm-hmm. but they want to breastfeed more. Mm-hmm. So it was more of a struggle mm-hmm. for me to like let her stop breastfeeding. But now with Megan, it's totally different mm-hmm. because she stopped on her own.
From your observation, how have the milestones been compared to first to second born?
I think we have this thing of if you have one baby, mm-hmm. you have this magnifying glass mm-hmm. on them. If they sit down today, you're going to notice and you're going to put it on Facebook, oh, my baby is sitting down. But when you have two babies,
yes.
and then you have this like attention division, mm-hmm. some milestones might slide. Okay, it's not a good thing.
Oh my gosh.
I'm not, you're like, hiya, why did you start making full sentences? It's been happening for a while. Where have I been? But you've been there. Mm-hmm. Only that, you know, when you have multiples now, mm-hmm. some things might slide by. But you will realize the smaller mm-hmm. one mm-hmm. catches up very fast.
Okay.
With the first one. Because even the feeding, as you're saying.
Yes.
I realized that Megan, by the time we started, okay, I do EBF. Mm-hmm. Okay. Which EBF is the... You breastfeed the baby until they are 6 months and you don't feed them anything else. Mm-hmm. And then from 6 months, now you give them food.
Yes.
But I realized by the time she's 9 months, 10 months, mm. she will not eat her food mm. at all. Mm. She wants to eat what everyone else is eating mm. because she can realize there's a difference. Mm. It tastes different.
What are the key challenges on top of your mind in a summary?
I think there's that the competitiveness.
For the close pacing.
The competitiveness is that. Mm-hmm. And then maybe, okay, challenges. Okay, the mom.
Yes.
I think right now I'm really tired. I don't know. I think it takes a toll on you, mm. like just having kids that close. Because mm. I remember my first pregnancy, right now I would have run a marathon. But mm. right now I'm thinking, hey, he's in his tears.
One of the ways that moms with kids, babies close together should do mm-hmm. is number one, routine your children. Mm-hmm. And so mm-hmm. that when you routine them, mm-hmm. then you make time for yourselves. Mm-hmm. So you know, like for example, like during the day, you're making sure they nap at the same time at a particular time. Mm-hmm. So you know, I have 2.5 hours where mm-hmm. they nap, and that's my me time. I'll do something that I need to do. I'll even take a nap myself. So routining, mm-hmm. having a routine for mm-hmm. the children because they're close together, mm-hmm. so their needs are basically almost the same,
mm-hmm. yeah.
will also give you time. Mm-hmm. Make use of family mm-hmm. And friends. Mm-hmm. Have a group support of moms that yes. possibly has children at the same time. Mm-hmm. I know, like for me, when my children were small, we had a group and would all say, we'll bring all our children to your house. And I go out and pamper myself, you know.
Is there any specific standard that mm-hmm. has probably been scientifically proven
yes.
for spacing babies? Because some mothers want to space their babies, give this child attention 5 years,
yes,
then when they're mm-hmm. off, now you start with the other one. Mm-hmm. Well, others opt for her, you know, finish with this chapter once and for all. Is there a standard?
Yes, there's a standard. Research shows that getting pregnant between 18 to 24 months mm-hmm. after your previous pregnancy mm-hmm. is the ideal. It gives your body time to replenish mm-hmm. the nutrients. Mm-hmm. Your body mm-hmm. takes a lot of toll bringing mm-hmm. a human being into this world, mm-hmm. and so you need time to heal. Need time to replenish the nutrients. Mm-hmm. Need time to just get back to a place where your body is ready to mm-hmm. carry another pregnancy, mm-hmm. but also not longer than 5 years.
Okay.
So it's between, the ideal is, let's say 24 months.
Mm-hmm. That's two years.
And then also don't wait until 5 years to get pregnant again. There are some risks also that has been associated with that.
Ah,
yes.
So there are risks for...
There are risks for short spacing, yes. and there are also risks for longer spacing. But usually, even if you're breastfeeding, you do need to stop at around 30 weeks mm-hmm. so that your milk can start, can revert to colostrum. Okay. Your mature milk can revert back to colostrum
for the newborn.
So that's around 6 months, you do need to to stop breastfeeding so that mature milk can stop.
Okay.
And we can make colostrum for the newborn.
So 30 weeks, yes. You stop breastfeeding
yes.
the other child.
The other child.
So that you have colostrum. That's yeah. very important information. Yes.